but I don't think so. All right, come on, move forward, because we got so much, too many seats in front. Or just anyone. Come on. There will be latecomers, so we'll let them take the back seats. That's always a good practice, right? So, appreciate it. All right. Pastor Phil's message today is about the witness, right? Who is the witness? We are the witnesses. We have witnessed how the Lord takes care of us, right? How He blesses us, how He provides for us. We have a testimony to tell the world how good the Lord is. Amen? And I actually have a very fresh story to tell and to share with you, if that's okay. Is that okay? If you recall, a few months ago, back in September, Pastor mentioned my personal situation in the message and how I had to make a change with my job because of the fact that I was being asked to basically put the company first. I made it very clear with that company, I was with them for 10 years, and I made it very clear that if I have a church commitment, I have to be there, and especially the worship team rehearsals on Fridays or the Bible studies, right? Well, they started requiring me to basically give that up and to put the company first. And so my response was, I don't think so, right? I explained that I am, first of all, a follower of Christ. Secondly, I'm a family man. And thirdly, an employee. They're asking me to switch my priorities, right? To put the company first, then God. That doesn't work. Okay? And so I ended up changing companies. Well, with a change in job come a change in health insurance, right? And I had to switch to another insurance company at that time and coverage, basically. Unfortunately, my new coverage didn't take effect until November 1st, 2017. So for the first time in my life, I actually found myself with no medical coverage for a few weeks, just for a few weeks, okay? Well, guess what? Jocelyn got pregnant during that week or during that time, right? It was like, are you kidding me? I paid so much money all these years on insurance, like, you know, thousands, and never used it. Now that we don't have any coverage, all of a sudden she gets pregnant. Yikes! You know? And to make it worse, I mean, not worse, but to make it more interesting, the insurance company said that they're declining our coverage, that they're not going to cover the maternity bills because they were saying that this is a pre-existing condition that week that she got pregnant before the effective date. Are you kidding me? Right? So it was unbelievable. It was an unbelievable experience. If you can just imagine, my joy in having a baby finally turned into a nightmare, right? I mean, the insurance company is not going to cover the maternity bills. Are you kidding me, right? And so it was like life was totally sucked out of me for a few weeks. And my smile totally disappeared upon learning that the insurance company is not going to cover our bills. I was like, is this really happening? The first time we went to see a doctor about the pregnancy was end of December. And yes, it was confirm that she is pregnant, okay? And so I was praying, are you, Lord, this is quite a sense of humor. I mean, I had insurance all this time, and just for a couple of weeks, we didn't have coverage. Now all of a sudden she gets pregnant, and the insurance company won't cover it. It was, you know, and here's the thing, to make it more interesting, it's a cesarean. As you know, cesarean is a lot more expensive than a normal delivery. It's double, you know, it's like, yikes. It was definitely unsettling at first, and I had some sleepless nights about it. During this time, I didn't even share it with Jocelyn because I didn't want her to stress over it, right? I mean, she didn't need that extra stress. But I started praying fervently, day and night. I prayed and prayed, and I spent more time worshiping the Lord, bowing really on my knees. Okay? I couldn't share it publicly because I didn't want Jocelyn to really worry about it if she finds out. And if you recall, I came forward for prayer, and I was just broken. I was broken. Okay. It was like the Lord was assuring me, just trust me. Just trust me. Okay. He wanted me to basically just rely on Him. He gave me peace in my heart during this time. After praying so much, after worshiping so much for weeks, and one of the nurses at the hospital, Mercy San Juan, in one of our visits, encouraged me to bring our situation up to their financial department, okay? And thinking that they might do something there. I mean, because again, the insurance won't cover our bills. The Lord led me to this lady at that department, and her name was Laura, and I really think she's an angel sent by God. This lady brought up our case to the financial department, and they reviewed it. They worked on it for 2 weeks. And just this last Monday, I got a call from Laura, and she was so excited. Roy, you were approved for the financial. And I was like, now if you can imagine, I'm driving to work, okay, when she calls me. This was even before 8 o'clock in the morning. And I started crying upon hearing her report. I started crying, and it was like, I was just so overjoyed that once again, my God came through. Amen. It was so. This morning, folks, I stand before you declaring that I am a witness of Christ. I know He lives. There's no doubt He's in charge of my life. Amen? And so, to God be the glory. But as we worship Him this morning, I want you all to really offer your hearts and minds on Him first of all. Let's worship Him in spirit and in truth, okay? As we do that, okay, and by the way, try to start getting comfortable worshiping the Lord, because when we get to heaven, it's all about worship, amen? So I would encourage you this morning, I would challenge you to just lift up your hearts to Him. Lift up your hands to Him as we worship Him, right? And as we worship, and I'm not saying as we sing songs. See, there's a big difference. We're not here to sing songs. We're here to worship the Lord. We're here to lift up our hearts to Him. Amen? So as we do that, humble yourself. Humble yourself before Him. Lift up your hands to Him. This is not worship, okay? Right? Posture is a big deal to the Lord, because He specifically told us exactly how to come to His throne. One way is to lift up our hands to Him. This is not biblical, right? So, as a worship team, our job is to encourage you to worship our Father. help us. We don't want to be a distraction, okay? Forgive us if we're being a distraction up here. But we want you to meet with the Lord. You are a witness of Christ. Amen? So we will do that this morning. We're going to enter into His gates with thanksgiving and into His courts with praise. Father, we thank You so much for this wonderful, wonderful morning You've given us. Lord, thank You for calling us to be Your witnesses. Thank You, O God, for all the great things You've done in our lives. Thank You for all Your provisions. You are Jehovah Jireh, our provider. You've always been there for us, O God. So, Lord, as we worship You this morning, I pray for everyone in this room that whoever's struggling will just come to You, humble himself or herself before You. Lift up their problems to You. Help them to do that, O Lord. Help them to do that this morning. We lift You up. We give You praise and glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen. He has made me glad. I will rejoice. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. Praise you, Lord Jesus. We've come to worship you this morning, O God. We've come to lift you up. We are your witnesses. Oh, Lord, thank you for calling us. Thank you for calling us to be your witnesses. Father, to be a witness, to be an effective witness, we need to learn to worship you. We ask for your forgiveness, O God, for we focus so much on too many other things. Oftentimes we neglect you. We forget about you. Forgive us, O God. You are the center of our worship, of our lives. Everything we do, we want to dedicate to you, Lord. Help us to grow in our worship. Teach us, O God, to worship you, to bow before you.
All about you, Jesus. I'm sorry.
bow before you. We humble ourselves, Lord. Lord, our prayer is that you will always shine. Shine, O God. Let our faces display your likeness wherever we are. Shine, Jesus, shine.
Father's glory, glades free. glory to your name. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to you, God. Glory to you, God. Glory to you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Father.
Lord, we continue to worship you now. For the rest of the worship service, we dedicate the rest of the time to you. In Jesus' name.